state violation of the complaint alleging the yellow line violation on the 11th day of August 2011 at about 3:55 in the afternoon. The complaint alleges that this occurred in the town of Dunbar on Concord State Road, that the pavement was dry, the traffic was medium, and the weather was clear. Sir, to this complaint, how do you plead? Are you ready for trial, sir?
Yeah.
All right, you may have a seat at that table right there. The state has the burden of proof is guilty beyond a reasonable doubt, so the state has to go first.
Mayor State, call the roll here. Raise your right hand. Swear any testimony you give today, the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth, and the pain, and the promise of perjury.
I do.
State your name, spell your last name, correct.
Trooper James O'Leary, O apostrophe L E A R Y.
Trooper, how long have you been employed by state police?
I've been a full-time law enforcement officer since 2005.
And during your time in becoming a state police officer, did you have training in the use of radar and other motor vehicle enforcement?
I did, sir. During my tenure running the New Hampshire State Police, or the New Hampshire Academy, 139 is a full-time academy graduate from. And that deal training beyond that.
And did you specifically receive training in radar deployment?
I did.
And were you certified as a radar operator on August 11th of last year?
I was.
And in August 11th of last year, were you working for state police at that time?
That is true.
And what was your patrol duties at that time?
On that time, I was assigned to the Division of Motor Vehicles in the Field Operations Bureau.
And around 3:55 in the afternoon, what town did you find yourself in?
I was traveling on Route 114 in the town of Dunbar.
What vehicle were you driving?
A fully marked New Hampshire State Police Cruiser.
And did you have a radar unit in that vehicle?
I did.
Yeah. What process did you go through that day to sort of to assure yourself that unit was working correctly?
In the morning when I began my shift, I utilized two tuning forks that I put in front of both the front and the rear cone of the radar unit, which will tell me whether or not it's operating properly. In addition to that, there was an internal test that's done by pressing a button inside on the unit, and everything was functioning properly at that moment.
Now, calling your attention specifically to events that occurred on Dunbar Road around 3:55 in the afternoon, did something unusual occur to find your attention?
That would be on Concord State Road.
I'm sorry.
That's okay, and which is also known as Route 114.
Your Honor, I ask that the court take judicial notice of that's a way to state your truth.
Very well.
Did something unusual happen on that road?
Yes, I recall traveling westbound on that road, and I observed a vehicle that was traveling east, was pulling a trailer. And my radar unit was on, and it displayed a reading of 47 miles per hour.
And what was this personnel speed limit in that area?
The speed limit in that area was 50 miles per hour.
Right. And did something occur after that?
Yes, I saw a vehicle that was behind the towing vehicle traveling eastbound that went to the westbound lane, passing the towing vehicle in the proper lane. As far as the markings were dotted at the time in which he began to pass. However, when we returned to the proper lane of travel, about 100 feet beyond the yellow solid line.
Now, the memory serves, that area on the stage road goes to passing, no passing, passing, no passing.
Correct.
And while you were observing these vehicles, did you observe the towing vehicle to increase its speed in any way?
I did not.
And so based on what you had seen, what action did you take?
I activated my emergency lights and I stopped that vehicle just west of Page's Country Store.
And did you engage the driver in conversation at that time?
I did. I identified him by his New Hampshire driver's license that indicated he was Sean Gravel, the individual I seated at the defense table here today.
Your Honor, to the record, will you find the identified the defendant?
Sure.
Go ahead. And then what conversation did you have with him at that point?
I explained to him the reason for the stop, and he told me at that time that the reason why he passed the vehicle was traveling too slow.
All right. Now, had gotten his license registration, did you return to your vehicle?
I did.
And after you had issued the citation, did you have another conversation with him?
I did. Upon issuing the citation, he then told me that the reason why he passed the vehicle was that it was all over the road and he needed to get around it.
Did you have occasion to have an additional conversation with him about the vehicle's operation that day?
I did.
And during that conversation, what explanation of his passing did you leave?
That conversation took place back in January, at which time we were here and he filed a motion to discover. And upon that day, he explained to me that the reason why he ended up in the no passing zone is because the towing vehicle was actually speeding up, which did not allow him to return to the property and travel in time.
All right.
Thank you.
So this is your opportunity to ask questions of the trooper. It's not your time to tell me your side of the story. That'll come in a moment. But if you have any questions for the trooper, you can stand and ask them those now.
Thank you.
So you say you first came upon the scene and witnessed me passing the truck?
When I first came upon the scene, we were not passing the truck.
Can you assess the speed of the truck traveling before I tried passing it?
Before you tried passing it, it was 47 miles per hour.
Okay, and can you confirm if the truck was carrying any kind of special load?
I know that it was towing a trailer. If I recall, it may be a snowmobile, but I don't know.
Had the truck had a trailer hitched to it, would you say that it would have been difficult for me to pass at the time?
I'm sorry, could you restate that?
If the truck was carrying a trailer, would it have made it more difficult for me to get around the entire truck and return the property and travel in the part of the time?
It would make the length of that vehicle probably double the average length of the vehicle.
What speed did you clock me at trying to pass the truck?
The radar unit did not hit on your car. Only hit on the towing vehicle.
Would you say that while passing a vehicle, there's a threshold at which point it would be safer to actually speed up and attempt to pass the vehicle than rather than slow down based upon coming traffic and attempting to get out of your lane?
I guess that is dependent on many variables.
Okay, variables like
that. I guess on the day that I saw you in that instance, I would say at that point, it would have probably been better not to pass the vehicle since it was at the end of the passing zone. It was only the passing zone prior to the point in which you passed the car.
Okay, so you would say that if I was like maybe noticing the truck, it would have been more difficult for me to actually take more time to actually slow down, get back behind the truck, behind the trailer, back into the proper lane of travel.
No, what I was saying was that if you were going to pass the vehicle, then what you should have done is pass it prior to the end of the passing lane.
Are you aware of this law that states that the driver must, and I'm quoting, as nearly as practicable, remain in the same lane of travel?
Sounds familiar.
So the state is now arrested. That means that's all the information you're going to give me concerning this case. This is your time during the trial where you present evidence, either by testifying and calling witnesses or presenting documents to the court. You have no obligation to do any of that if you don't want to, because the burden is on the state to prove you guilty beyond a reasonable doubt. If you do desire to testify, present any evidence, you can stand and do that now.
I only have a short statement. I just want to say that I did what I did.
Do you want to testify or do you want to use that statement in argument? All right. You swear the testimony you're about to give in the matter of hearing before this court is the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, the Son of God.
I do.
Be seated. And you're Sean Rebell?
Yes.
All right, Sean, what would you like the court to know?
On the day in question, I was traveling west. Traveling east on the state road. And I was following a truck with a large trailer hitched to it, because I don't recall what it was carrying. The truck was moving erratically.
need to have to go over the yellow line upon entry of the proper lane travel.
All right, anything else? Any questions?
You didn't call in the vehicle to the local police department, right?
The trailer was actually blocking the license plate of the vehicle.
Well, the trailer.
I also don't use the cell phone while driving.
Okay. So the answer is no.
Right.
Okay. So, and there, you didn't tell the trooper that you had an emergency that day, right?
Right.
So you would have just gone slower, but you also avoided any kind of confrontation with that vehicle by just going slower.
I did notify the trooper that the truck was moving erratically.
But I understand. Yes, but you personally didn't have some kind of emergency that you that necessitated you getting to Concord faster, getting away from Concord faster, or getting direction from Concord.
No.
Okay. So you could have accomplished your goal of not having a confrontation with the vehicle by going slower. Is that true?
I suppose.
Okay. Thank you.
Anything else you want me to know, sir?
Nothing.
All right, bring it back to your table. Do you have any other witnesses or documents that you want to present to the court?
No.
All right, may I stand? You want to argue the case or have I heard everything?
No.
All right. Well, I'm going to enter a finding of guilty. Is there a prior motor vehicle record?
There is, Your Honor, in terms of motor vehicle related offenses. Reckless operation in 2009 and an illegal backing, which appears to be from the same incident also in 2009. In that note, I'm going to be
all right. And you want to say?
No.
I'm going to impose the standard fine of $103.33. I'm going to suspend the entire fine to cure you the year. No further motor vehicle convictions. You understand that?
Yes.
That means if you don't have any further motor vehicle convictions in the next 12 months, you don't have to pay that. Thank you.
That's not your jacket, is it?